Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. So yeah, finally a get ready. Something has to go in my eye. Yeah, finally a get ready with me, and I'm going to answer the questions you asked as well. I'm just going to give what has been happening. The September series is over. I am so glad. Today is October 2nd and I'm done with the September series. And yeah, we're going to talk about all those things. I do have all my questions noted and I'm trying to be a little organized. Usually what I do is I go through my phone, scroll and answer, but that takes so much of time. So this time I kind of noted all the questions. And we have 23-24. I'm going to try to answer everything. Like I noted down, combine a lot of things and I noted down questions. So they might not be the exact same words, but you know, the questions are similar. And I think that's it. Let's get started. Also, by the way, if there's a lot of noise, I'm very, very sorry. It is super hot today and either it's too hot or either it's too humid. I wish there's a balance. I can't wait for winter. I really can't wait for winter. So yeah, anyway, like there's a fan which I put because it's supremely hot, so don't mind that. Now we're going to start off with our base, and I just want to do something very pretty. I just want to feel very pretty. So something I do the best is pink. So we're going to play with pink today. For primer, I'm going in with this Bobbi Brown Whiteman Enriched Face Base. I use this a couple of times. The finish is really good, but it says it has shea butter in it, and shea butter can be a little heavy for somebody who has oily skin, so I need to try it a couple more times, but it does give a very beautiful flawless finish, so I can try it a few more times and then I'll understand if it's actually making me break out. So all the details of the makeup products will be in the description below. I'm just going to concentrate on talking. If you don't like me talking, then do exit this video, because I'm going to talk a lot. I'm going to do two things which I love the most, that is makeup and talking. So if that's not your jam, kindly leave. Don't say that I talk too much. It's literally a talking video. So I'm gonna talk. So first I'm just going to answer the basic questions. Hi, my name is Akanksha. I'm 23 years old. I live in Hyderabad. I'm a Telugu girl. My mother tongue is Telugu. My father tongue is Telugu. I'm a proper Telugu girl. I started out in June 2019. Like I started the YouTube channel and Instagram on around June 2019. And what was one more question was, I wrote those down also, the most commonly asked questions. And yeah, I'm 5.7 because a lot of people are curious about my height. So I did my engineering. So basically I'm like a graduate. I did my engineering in Pune, Symbiosis International University. I was in Pune for 4 years and then I came to Hyderabad. Yeah, I think those are the most basic questions. Now, I think next time I'm just gonna answer, like talk whatever I want to. Let's start off with September. My God. So I decided to do this OOTD series. I thought, it might be easy. It might not be that difficult. Just like OOTD, I started off like that. And the worst thing I did is I didn't pre-film. Maybe if I pre-filmed, it would have been a little easier. It's not the most difficult thing, but because my house is getting renovated and I'm staying in some other house, basically like a rented house, I don't have anything organized. I don't have my jewelry in one place. I don't have, like, there's everything is very cluttered. It's in boxes. So for me to try and arrange an outfit and then pull out a bag, it was a very like time consuming, which kind of was a little difficult. Had it been like, I have a very proper setup, I know where everything is, it would have been a little easier. But nevertheless, I did it. I didn't even miss one day, which I'm super proud of. And it was a mixed opinion, the feedback was mixed, but I did what I did. I wanted to keep it basic and that's why I did, because it's like OOTD and that's something I would generally wear. I think majority was positive, which I'm really glad. Now obviously I am going to continue making outfit videos, but those are going to be a little more fun to watch, not just like boring OOTDs. And September was a big month because I started working out. I think I started working out 2nd September. I'm a person, I never worked out in my entire life. It's very bad to say that. I mean, it's very sad that I have to say that, but I never worked out before. And being a PCOD person, workout is like one of the most important things. So anyway, due to the lockdown, we're all at home. And I started feeling like, you know, I'm actually at home since last 1 year. Like after engineering was done, I came back home. And since then I'm at home. I used to go out during weekends to meet my friends. But during the weekdays, I was always at home because like, you know, my work is from home. So that, and like, you know, but like, post lockdown, even that was not there. I think I literally went out maybe like 10-15 times in like this past 6 months. So there was no physical activity whatsoever, and I just started like, you know, feeling that my body is not good anymore. So I was like, you know, I started like, I literally used to film one like, you know, Instagram video, and I used to be so damn tired. I was like, you know, this is not done. I think that point was like, you know, I need to start training. And basically I started training for that. I wanted to become stronger. I didn't want to feel so tired all the time. And I'm a person who wakes up late, sleeps late and wakes up late. I always wanted to wake up early, but I don't know, it was just never me. And so what I did is I scheduled my I took a trainer and I put my slot for 9 o'clock, so for sure that I'll wake up at 9 o'clock. Usually I used to like, you know, give a justification ki what do I even have to do. Like if I wake up early, there's nothing I have to do. I literally film in the afternoon, so there's nothing I need to do, so why to wake up early? So what I did was I took a slot at 9 o'clock in the morning, which makes me sleep early and wake up early as well. But for a person who's used to, like even during college, I was used to sleeping so late, like at least so late, and even at least 2 o'clock, 2:30, and then I still wake up. But you know, I'm used to sleeping very you know, late. But past 1 year I've been getting up even late, like even in the morning I was getting up late. So I really wanted to change that, because like if you wake up at 11 and 12, the day literally gets over. So waking up in the morning, then I started working out, and you know, there were so many things which were very exhausting. First month of working out, and for a person who never worked out before, it was really hard. And I do intermittent fasting, okay? So like I eat my last meal at 8:30 in the night, and I eat my next meal, like the first meal in the day, at 12 o'clock. So basically I fast for 16 hours, and in the morning 9 hours, basically that's like almost 12-13 hours of fasting. Working out during a fasting period also was very, very difficult, and my trainer and I had to like work really hard for my body to get used to it. I think now it's been a month, I'm good. I don't feel exhausted all day after working out. The first 3 weeks, 4 weeks, I was literally so exhausted after working out, and that's bound to happen if you initially start working out. So that's like, you know, fine. I kept pushing myself. I'm like, you know, this is always the initial stage of starting something. You need to do it. I was training my mind and like, I've got to do it. I train 4 days a week, which has been amazing. Like I just want to feel stronger. So when I got the trainer, he even asked me like, you know, what do you want to do? Like he said like, you know, what's your goal? Like, do you want to lose weight? Do you want like any goals, like anything? I said, I just want to move, bro. Like every single day I want to do some activity so that my body just doesn't get numb. And he was like, yeah, that's, I basically just wanted to get stronger. I'm a person, like I look like I'm 5'7", I'm like 63-64. I look like, you know, big and strong, but I am very, very like, you know, weak. So I don't have any strength at all in my body. I've never been like into sports or into like physical activities also. Like as a kid, I used to just play badminton, and that's, you know, about it. So I wanted to become stronger. I wanted my upper body, especially my arms. My arms are so weak, I cannot lift things easily. I that was very bothering. I just want myself to feel a lot stronger, and already in 1 month I see huge difference. I think I really have to appreciate my trainer. I told him, ki bro, you know, here's the situation. I never worked out in my entire life, so I think we have to take this slow, because I don't think, because usually whenever I started working out, I did try to work out a couple of times before, but you know, it's like 2 weeks in, 3 weeks in, and I stop, because usually I start like you know, I follow somebody's workout or I do something else. I never had a trainer before. So I think I have to give him a lot of credit because he built up the strength rather than stressing me out first only. And I mean, I did feel tired. We did do like high intensity workouts. But like, you know, there's a way you, everybody's body is different and it's very way you build it up, right? So I think that kind of like helped me really well. And now even on fasting, first few days were very difficult. The first 3 days, literally, I used to feel so dizzy. We used to like stop working out. At a point, I was like, you know, I'm feeling very dizzy. I have to have something sweet. I had to have something sweet and break my fast, which I didn't really want to because intermittent fasting is something really, really good. Matlab, at least for me, it was. And it has so many benefits and I didn't want to like leave it just for like working out. And I wanted my body to get used to working out during the intermittent fasting. So the first 3 days was really bad, and I think one of the day I even puked because like of the intensity. Like I couldn't take it, even though it was low intensity for my body, it was very high intensity. So and then slowly it got stronger. Sometimes I do like used to feel dizzy, I think, but then past like 1 week to like, you know, 10 days, I've been like a lot better in terms of like dizziness or pukishness or feeling weak in the morning, which is, I feel so happy about. That means like, you know, my body did get used to, you know, working out in the morning. So yeah, there's a lot of working out thing I'm talking about because these are all things which happened in September. And one more is my house renovation. There was a lot of things going on with the tiles we had to choose for the bathroom. So much mess. I think I talked about that in my house video because or else this will be very long. Let's say we got one tile, but they sent one tile and we didn't check that. We checked that after the tile person stuck it to the wall, and then we had to there was a whole thing. So I've constantly run, like not like constantly, but we had some things to do around the house as well. So that was also then it was constantly raining. My god, every time I had little time to film, it used to like start raining super much, and then I didn't have like proper lighting to film, and I had to post every single day, like, you know, so many things. But I'm not complaining. No way am I complaining ki, oh, I do so much work. It's part of the job. It's a lot less than what other people do. But, you know, I'm just giving an update of what happened. I'm a person, I'm gonna say, I'm not like a very like big hard worker. I do my work, but I'm not like somebody who works so intense. I just cannot do it. I really want to get there. But I'm just working on it. But so the amount of work which I had was very overwhelming because I am a lazy person, super lazy. So it was really nice when I completed the September series. September series was just like a pat on the back for me. I was like, when I finished that and I didn't miss one day, I was like, I am so proud of myself. I literally used to like, you know, get my trainer in mind. I was like, you know, 3 more, 2 more, 1 more. Like, you know, you're almost done, Akanksha. You don't have to skip. Don't skip. I'm like, yes. So that was September, and September had more amazing things as well. I hit 50,000 on Instagram. Yay! If you don't follow me on Instagram, you can follow me. I hit 30,000 on YouTube. Thank Lord. I feel very bad that I neglected YouTube for a while. Like, I think in the initial 6 months, I was just like Instagram. I think it was in a sense that, you know, you get response in one platform, you start going there, but that was a huge mistake. I should have worked on getting better on YouTube as well. And I'm trying, so that's like really nice. And thank you so much for 35,000 of you now. And yeah, I had to celebrate. Like, I still didn't celebrate it with my friends. I didn't like meet everybody after I hit 50k, but I'm super happy. They sent me cake, which was very sweet. I love celebrating small moments. I'm that person who will celebrate everything. I used to not be that person who celebrates every small thing, you know, just to brush off and act like, you know, it's not a big deal. But I realized that, you know, I am a person who loves to celebrate, but I was just not to just, you know, try to act cool. I don't know, it was just something. You're like, you know, maybe I should not celebrate. Maybe it's not big of a deal, but it is a big of a deal for me sometimes, and I want to celebrate that. And I think everybody should, because these are the things when you look back are something you would remember, because these milestones don't come again and again. Last year June, if you told me that in like 1 year you're gonna hit 50k, I would like, you know, sure, I don't think I would have believed. But you know, now we are here and I'm really, really grateful, and I want to celebrate that. I want to celebrate everything. I worked hard for it, and you know, it is like, it's not like I just like slept and overnight I got, you know, 50,000 followers. So really, really grateful. I actually have one of the sweetest audience ever. I don't know, everybody is so loving, let's say for my work or let's say for anything, especially towards my sister. So damn sweet. I really, really like how you guys are. I think as a creator, all you can give as an audience is to explore options and tell, like, critiquing. Like, I get a lot of criticism from my audience as well, but I am so glad, touch wood, that it's 99% of very, very constructive criticism, which I'm very, very glad of. And a lot of people DM me about it because they think like it might be rude in the comments and all, which are, it's like so thoughtful, and which makes me feel like really, really nice. So I have really mature audience. Like, there are of course dumb shit people, but you know, they're going to be like that and we cannot change that. So now, moving on to your questions, I already know it's gonna be a long one because it's already 23 minutes since I started filming and I spoke a lot already, so this is going to be quite long. First question is, what's your score in 10th and 11th boards, and what was your stream? My stream was MPC, so that's the reason like I could do engineering. Coming to the score, I was never a very studious kind of girl. I just studied for the sake of it. So my scores were like not that great. So in 10th, I was in ICIC board and I got, I think, around 78 or 79. I rounded up and tell it like 80. It was around 78 or something. And in inter, inter is basically 12th and 11th and 12th in Hyderabad, we call inter. And like, I was in SSC board, like state board is quite easy. And I was in hostel, so I got around, it's around on 1,000 marks. So for 1,000, I got some 955 or something like that. But it's like, you know, it was quite easy. Next question is, do you wish to do further studies? I didn't even do my brows. I don't know what I'm trying to clean up. Yeah, I don't know for sure if I am going to, but I always wanted to do MBA. So maybe one day when the time is right, not at this point of my life, but I really want to do MBA. And yeah, let's see how that goes. Next question is, any plans to settle in Mumbai? They were like, you know, related to questions in Mumbai, that do you think there are opportunities in Mumbai also? So I don't have plans in for settling in Mumbai for sure, but you know, coming to opportunities, maybe I do think people in Mumbai have more opportunities. In the sense, like, let's say there's an ex-girl who has set same amount of followers of me, and there is, like, she lives in Mumbai, and then there's me who lives in Hyderabad, has the same amount of followers. So if the brand wants me, of course there's going to be a different impact of people, like, you know, depends on, you know, the influencer. But of course, you know, if they want to see in the budget, if they fly me down for something, it will cost them more, because you know, there's flight expenses, cab expenses, hotel expenses, versus the girl who's in Mumbai, it just like takes cab expenses for them to, you know, go and do a shoot with them. So I think maybe in that perspective, but of course there are few brands, you know, who are very specific about the influencer they want. But yeah, maybe I do think Mumbai has more opportunities, but I don't think I want to shift to Mumbai for sure. I've been to Mumbai, I don't think Mumbai is a city for me. It's not that I don't think Mumbai is city for me. I think Hyderabad is the city for me. Hyderabad feels home. Any given day, my concealer fell down saying that it is true. Hyderabad is home. I've been here since past 21 years and it just feels home. My family is here, everybody is here. I don't think I want to settle anywhere also. I think I'm gonna settle in Hyderabad. Like 99%, like post-marriage, anything, I think I'm going to like stay in Hyderabad. Ha, next question. Why are you the only Telugu YouTuber who doesn't talk about skin lightening? Now, people who talk about skin lightening, I don't know why they do that. I don't understand it. I know, no, actually that's not true. I don't think there's, I'm the only one. I know one more YouTuber who is Telugu and she doesn't promote skin lightening either. I think it's just like perspective. I would never do that. I don't know how to answer that. Like, why? Because I don't believe in skin lightening. I don't believe that something person has to do. So that's the reason I don't promote it, and I wish nobody else did. A lot of people still promote it, so that's sad. Next question is, how do you deal with judgments or comments regarding your acne? So today morning only, I actually posted just a few hours ago a few comments about somebody. So initially it did affect me. But like, I think at this point I grew a little bit of thick skin. I mean, sometimes it does get to me, but like, you know, today's morning comment was something like, you know, the person is telling me in a very polite way, you know, your skin is getting bad, why don't you take a big, like, you know, break for makeup? And like, why do you have to tell me my skin is getting worse? Like, it's not even worse. Something, she said something, and I'm like, do you think I don't have eyes? Do you think I cannot see? Do you think I don't know? What do you think? Do you think I don't wash my face? I don't know. Like, you know, what is the person? And, you know, people say, talk, and I at this point have made peace, but I'm going to educate people as much as I can to say that you are not supposed to talk to people in a certain way. Talk people, like telling people and pointing people about their insecurity is one of the worst thing as a human being you can do. So I don't know what their issue is, like why they think feel so entitled to point out somebody's skin issues where like they are dealing with. Obviously it's not like the person cannot see they have pimples. It's not like the person doesn't see their face in the mirror every single day, right? See, my thing is all on makeup. Like, you wear makeup, that's the reason you're breaking out. I can name 100 people I know who wear makeup like I do, but have beautiful, flawless skin. One of the well-known creators in India, let's say Jovita has beautiful skin, Shreya Jain has beautiful skin, Malvika has beautiful skin. All of them wear makeup every single, maybe not every single day, but they wear makeup often. And you know, makeup is not the reason. And I know, see, of course, there are few people who might affected by makeup. If they don't remove it properly, but I know for a fact that my skin is not. I've told this a number of times, and I am really tired of telling this anymore. So I don't even know why I'm concentrating on this question so much. There was some stupid residue left on the brush, and my eye is black now instead of pink. But anyway, I like, you know, I just stopped giving a shit about people and started appreciating my skin. It's healing, guys. It's trying, and I'm going to give it time to do its thing. It's not something I did it wantedly. Now, one more question is, again, since when are you suffering from acne? I think since my 9th grade or 8th grade, like since I started getting periods, so that would be like 8th grade. And till date I do suffer. Beachmate, it was a little aggressive, a lot aggressive than it is right now, but it got better, and now again it's going to get better, so I really don't care. It's not like I didn't see dermatologist, I didn't try to get help. I did, it just never really worked out for me really well. Oh my god, I hate dermatologists who make you feel terrible about yourself. So recently I went somewhere, and I'm not gonna name. I went there for skin, like I wanted to pay with like my own money and get a treatment done. And like I went there, and then the doctor said, oh yes, you really need the treatment. Look at your face, you know, you have a lot of thing, and then you know, you have pores as well, so you need to get treated that as well. If somebody is gonna talk like that, see, there's a way to tell. I agree, I know my skin is bad, but there's a polite way to say it. There's a way to say how the treatment is done. And there are dermatologists who like that. I went to a dermatologist who's very kind, very sweet, talk very nicely, and that makes me feel good, and then take the treatment as well. After she said that, I'm like, you know, bye. I'm not gonna come back here. I'm not gonna get the treatment done by you. I'm going to go anywhere else. And I didn't go there for pigmentation, like acne pigmentation will go off in like 2-3 months. But I do have a little bit of indentation right here, so I was like, you know, why not get it treated. I just went there just to check it out, and really bad. Like I there's a way to talk to people. I mean, you cannot make them feel bad and actually tell them that they didn't, like, for a person who doesn't even know that they have a problem. I really didn't know that I had large pores. I really don't think so. Even now, I don't think so. I have huge pores. But she saying that made me feel horrible, like horrible in the sense, horrible about her, that she's a horrible person to have said that. So next question is, do you plan on moving out and having a place of your own? At the moment, I don't. I lived in a flat by myself for 2 years. When I was in Pune, I lived in a flat. Like, I had a roommate, both of us used to live together. So I did live outside and I know the lifestyle. I did get used to it. There's a lot of freedom, that is for sure. I do miss that at home sometimes. But if I move out, it would be with somebody. Like, if I have a friend, like if my best friend wants to move out, then maybe I will think about it. Or if if I have a partner and I feel like I want to move out, maybe that time. But I don't want to move out alone. I know for a fact that I don't want to live alone. Back in the day, like even when I was like in my flat and my roommate used to not be there, I used to feel really lonely. Like not there immediately, but you know, at a prolonged time, if I'm staying alone, I think I'm not that person who can likes to live alone. When I come out of my room, I like having somebody to talk to. So I need some company. Maybe like if I do, then I might consider. But now I am very happy. I'm very pampered at home. So I'm very happy to stay at home and be where I am. Now, another very common question is, have you ever been called out for being dusky or being shamed for being dusky, and how do you deal with it? So I've never been called dusky because I am not dusky. I don't know why. I look a lot deeper than what I am on camera, irrespective of sunlight, whatever. Really, in Indian like terms, I am that fair medium type of girl. Like, I'm not like as fair as a Kashmiri, but I am fair, like fair in the terms of like the society. So I've never been called dusky and I've never like experienced that. But I do think I am like I do consider myself tan. I do consider myself like that, you know, medium deep category, which is like a universal category for my skin tone. I've not faced, you know, things like somebody calling me dark or dusky or ugly, but I have like places where people said, you know, if I get a little tan, oh, you got too tan, you like, you know, you get rid of it, or you look like, you know, and those type of things. I'm like, you know what, this is 2020 and you need to get over it. So those things actually never bother me. I don't know why, and I'm happy they don't bother, or else it would just sit in my head constantly. I've never called dark. I have been called out for other things, like, oh, like, you know, your feet are too dark, you need to do something about it. You need to, like, your lips are too dark, you need to do something about it. And I don't know, I never really cared. It's sad that a lot of people, like, you know, face issues with this. But thank God I never had, like, I was never very, very insecure about my lips being dark or my legs being dark. I mean, it's just like common thing which I thought was always there. And yeah, my makeup looks very bad today because I ruined this eye. I think I kind of try to match. So next question is, when am I getting married? So I'm 23 now, not until at least 3 more years. It's not like I have a deadline for my parents, but I think I will be ready after 26 or 27. My sister is 27 and a half now, and she is not married. So it's not like I have like any deadline. At least nothing for more 3 to 4 years. That is for sure. So yeah, you don't have to get your wedding dresses ready. So best go-to place to hang out in Hyderabad. So I have not been to a lot of places in Hyderabad. So like I told you, I was in engineering, like I did my engineering in Pune, right? So for 4 years, I know a lot of places in Pune and I have a lot of like go-to places in Pune. But in Hyderabad, I still don't have one. My friends have this lounge which they usually chill. It's called Mustang. It's in Gachibowli. So that actually they chill because it's really close to their office. Or like all the offices are like in Gachibowli in Hyderabad. So there they go. But one place I think recently, before lockdown, there was only 6 months for me to really roam. I think in that 6 months, I roamed like few places. But Tivola Cafe has really, really good food. Then I went to, like, they have Tiki Shack and all, but I mean, I went there, but it's not like my regular place. And yeah, I like really, I go wherever my friends take me, like there, Adda is like Mustang and everything. So like I go there. Next question is, what do I enjoy doing aside, like besides makeup? So makeup used to be my fun like hobby, which I really like to do, but now it has become my job. And it, you know, of course it can't be like a hobby anymore. So I really, I am trying to find a good, like, you know, new hobby, because I can't keep doing makeup all the time. It will get very like monotonous. I don't know if that's a, like the right word to use. I'm really trying to, like, you know, see something which I really like to do other than makeup. I'm trying to find a hobby, because of course everybody needs a break, and other than just like sitting and watching Netflix all the time, I think this would be better. You were talking about Netflix. It has been over a month. Like yesterday night I was little free, but like over the month, like I told you, exhaustion, I have to sleep at 1, wake up at 8. So I didn't watch anything for the past month or so. No Netflix, no Prime. I used to watch like here and there videos on YouTube sometimes, and yeah, that's it. Like I literally didn't even watch anything new on Netflix. I'm thinking I really, really want to start Schitt's Creek now that I have time. I might, you know, start that. And I actually watched Social Dilemma, I think like 2-3 weeks ago, but that also was like, I think 1 hour show, and I watched like in 4 different periods, like, you know, 20 minutes, like 10 minutes, like that, and then I finished it. So next question is, your honest journey, the other side of your journey, which you didn't let us know. I think like that will be our last question. There was a period, it was not like, I don't know what to say, it was good or bad. So the first 6 months, or basically like the first 6 to 7, 8 months actually, until like February also, I started out this like with like what, 500, 1,000 followers. Those were my friends at that time. I didn't make money for like, I mean, good enough of money from collaborations. Like, thank God, touch wood, one of my YouTube video went viral, so I did make like good amount of money from that. But other than that, like, let's say talk about collaborations and all, I was not making much money. And like, once you're done with engineering, and like, that's like a very critical period where you need to get a job. But I was not like, you know, trying for a job, and I was trying for this, and like I didn't know this was going to go any further. I mean, in November I hit 10k, but of course, like, you know, until you have a certain number of followers, it won't be like, you know, you're like earning crazy amount. So I was you know, a little like, money was a little, you know, bit of issue. Like, luckily I stay in my house with my parents. My earning money is not an essential for my household, but of course it's like, for me, I would like, you know, feel nice if I'm earning, right? Like, I mean, of course I need a stable amount of income. So and even if I did get collaborations, like, I cannot bargain for like, you know, shit. I didn't know the market value. It's very overwhelming. So I didn't make money. Even if I like, you know, got collaborations, I used to like not like it, so just not do it. And then if I like something, I like, the price used to be too less, etc, etc. Thank God YouTube gave me that one video, gave me a little bit of money to sustain a few months. And I did get collaborations here and there. I did little freelancing back then as well, so I used to make money there. But I was a little scared in terms of money. I'm not gonna lie, you know, am I going to make money? Like, if it's gonna be like this, then it might be a little difficult. I think that was the only thing which was a little of my journey which I didn't share, that I did what I did, but I was not making much money until like Jan-Feb. I think now I don't have that fear, but back then I was kind of a little worried about my income, my budget and all such things. So yeah guys, that's about it. A little Q&A, get ready with me. Maybe not little, it was quite long. I can see that it is pretty long. But yeah, that's about it. And I hope you got to know me better. And that's it for today's video. I'll see you guys in my next video. Until then, make sure you like, share and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!